Hey everybody, Roxabox90 here with a camera, amazingly enough, and a tripod, another amazing feat. And we have here two monthly magic boxes. And the reason why we do is one, because one came in late for me, and the other reason is because I wanted to do an experiment case study where I have two magic boxes and put them next to each other and see if there's any change month over month, because so far we've seen boxes that are really good, we've seen boxes that are pretty bad, and now I think it's important that we take a look and see what we got here for this. So this was, I believe, the August box, and this is the September box. So let's see what came inside the August box. The August box, first we get here a Ultra Pro deck box, which is, pretty much, it holds 180 cards. And it's one of those, like, you flip open the top and it holds cards. So it comes with one of these, which I can only imagine it's probably not horribly expensive for these. Maybe $10, less than $10. I can't imagine it's expensive. And then we get another pack of Ultra Pro sleeves, this time Garrick, which look good, but as we know, the quality on these are usually pretty low. And these go for anywhere from $6, $7, $8 in terms of retail price. And then we get three magic packs, and I don't know what happened to it, but there was a piece of taffy something as well. So we do get technically our six products, but the candy thing is never included as a magic product, which means we really only get five, not six magic products here. And the retail value in this, even if you're being generous and these are $4 a pack, which I rarely get that, then let's say this is $12 plus eight, that's 20 plus, I can't imagine this is more than five-ish dollars, but all right, the value seems fairly low. And again, maybe you'll get your money back on this one, but the candy doesn't count, and so you end up getting five magic products. We'll open the packs after, but let's see what came in September. Did they get any better, worse, etc.? So we get three packs again. This time M15 is now in the mix, and cons will probably be in the future, I guess, if they continue doing this. We get one of these 80 sleeve holders, which these are nothing. These are maybe a couple dollars. You can get these very easily. This is a new brand, for me at least. I've never seen BCW. It may be well known or not. I don't know about the quality is. You probably want to check out Tulare Community College for quality on these kinds of things. He does a really great series on those things. Just plugged. But here we go. So that's probably a couple dollars. And then we got a candy piece also, which is also missing. Not because I ate it, but I don't know where it went. And then we got here a portfolio, which I saw online was, I think you get it for less than $10. You can get it as a retail from the BCW website, which I'm sure means, sure you can get it for cheaper. So here you get barely 25, probably less dollars. And you're getting more and more sleeves and boxes and portfolios and things like that. And you're not really getting any sort of other variety of magic things, which is kind of, I don't know. For me, I don't really take a stance on the products. I kind of just, they sent it to me, I'm showing it to you what is here. But I do want to make clear here that I'm seeing a trend, which is that nothing's really changing about the magic box. You kind of are getting the same thing, which means that it doesn't seem to be a great investment for putting, I think it's $24.99 for a month, or per month per month. $25 for this kind of stuff, even if you're putting that money into your local game store, you're probably still going to end up getting more value than you would have this, especially once you get a couple of these, you're pretty much set in terms of sleeves and stuff. So for me, it seems like a murky investment in terms of putting your money towards it. And the bigger problem is that they haven't really tried to accelerate or do anything big or better, showing that it's going to be worth your time to stick with them. They kind of haven't learned from that, from people who have complained against putting the same kind of products, kind of messing around by putting candy instead of a sixth magic product, etc., etc. Nothing has really shifted or changed since we started opening these, and now we see side by side, it's pretty much the same thing. You're barely breaking even. You probably, even at your local game store, could get stuff for less than the 25 that you pay. So for me, there are other products that are similar to these, and I will put them down below if you guys want to check those out, compare it to the Magic Monthly box, and make a decision on whether you're interested in this kind of thing or not. There definitely does seem to be a factual lack of change and lack of growing quality for this product. So that's my two cents. Packs and see if we get anything crazy. The sleeve packs and things I don't really think we need to open, but let's see. For the August box. We'll have it fight off against the September box. They both have three packs. Let's check it out. We have a Theros block opening. How are we going to do? So for Theros, for you. All right, we got a bunch of commons. We got a Mogus's Marauders, Horizon Chimera, Satyr Piper. For some reason, there's like a blurriness to it, and a Temple of Silence. Hey, that's not too bad. Can't fight with that. All right, next up, we got a Born of the Gods. Alright, Born of the Gods, we got Rise of the Challenge, Nyx Born, whatever. And you guys pretty much have seen a billion of these openings before. We got a Thunderbrute, Sanguimancy, Trinity Snare, and a Faded Conflagration. Alrighty. We got Satyr Hoplite. Got some commons, Bisara Tower Archer, Blinding Flare, Stormborn Giant, Dictate of Krufix, no foil. Okay, so that was our first box. Now, start with M15. Got some interesting cards here. Insol Artifact, that's pretty cool. Jace's Ingenuity. Circle of Flame. Yisan the Wanderer Bard. And a forest and a dragon. Okay. Theros. Got a Horizon Scholar. Chronicler of Heroes, Coordinated Assault, Underworld Cerberus, the guy I want to be really good. But for some reason, he's just not getting there. But he's mythic. That's kind of cool. And we got, last up, Stormcoral of Kernos, Ornitharch, Ragemonger, Pharah, and a foil, Griffin Dreamfinder. Nice. Mythic. Very cool. Two mythics. Awesome sauce, as smarter people than me like to call it. So this is our monthly Magic Box dual opening. So we have August and we have September. We got some pretty cool pulls. Better ones, obviously, in the September box than here. But as I said before, I don't think that the Magic Monthly box has really been growing or changing or doing anything particularly innovative. Price-wise, it's questionable whether it's a value decision. I've also been putting candy, which makes it a questionable as well, where it's like, what is this candy doing here as one of the magic products? It's not a magic product. There's a lot of stuff about it that at this point has been repeated enough for me to say that it's kind of strange, and to repeat enough for me to say that I'm not so sure this is the greatest investment, given that there are other options out there that I think may or may not be better. And I think that before you go and jump on the monthly Magic Box, you should definitely go check out other options and consider whether this is for you. So thanks for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed the video, tap the like button. If you're new to the channel, check in and subscribe. As always, Roxabox90 signing out. I'll see you guys next time.